For the last few days, there have been countless stories retold of that fateful day in September 2001. Stories of loss, grief, hope and heroism. But this next story is truly remarkable. Ron DeFrancesco was one of the lucky ones. Not only did he survive the terror attacks, he is said to be the last known man to make it out of the South Tower alive. I had the honour of speaking with him to mark this year's 20th anniversary.
I worked on the 84th floor of the South Tower. I was in the office. I'm usually in the office about 10 to 7 in the morning. It was just a normal, beautiful, sunny day. And our trading room, so we had about 350 people in there. And it was alive with activity, a lot of buzzing going on. We were sitting at our desks and engaged in our day when back to the right, there was this big loud explosion. And we looked and we saw a fireball coming in on itself. And then we saw thousands upon thousands of paper. We ran over to see what had happened. And then we saw the big gaping hole in the first tower.
For you in the second tower, what was your thought about what had happened and what you were to do next?
So for me, there's conflicting things. One is the Port Authority, who ran the World Trade Center, had said that Building 2 is secure and that people should go back to their desk. And nobody knew what had gone on, but never in my mind did I think it was terrorism. I was at my desk still, and a good friend of mine from Toronto, who was a bond trader, called me and just basically started screaming at me to get out of the building now. And he incited a bit of fear in me, which was a good thing, because as I was leaving the trading room, the plane hit our building and the wing sliced through our trading room. You know, we got ourselves up and got to followed a bunch of people into the stairwell. When we started to go down, we met this heavyset lady coming up, being carried by two men. And she told us that we couldn't go down further below. There was no escape. There was too much fire and too much flame. I was overcome with the smoke and started to climb up the stairs with some of my other colleagues. I guess I got to about the 91st floor and realized we couldn't get out. At that point, panic set in and I realized I needed to see my wife and kids again, so I headed back down. But as I was heading back down, the smoke was quite thick and heavy, and people were starting to drift off and go to sleep. Someone called me, and it was a clear, calm voice and basically told me to come this way. Some people say it's my adrenaline-fueled synapses. Others say it's an angel. Others say it's a god, right? And I'm a god-believing person, so somebody helped me out of there. And I went towards the thickest of the smoke. And in the last-ditch effort for air, I just pulled. And I pulled back a sheet of drywall. And saw the staircase below. So I slid down the drywall and then I ran through three flights of stairs that were on fire. They wouldn't let us outside of the building because there was too much debris and fires and there were people jumping still, right? And so for our own safety, they made us go down and through the concourse area and to get out at an area that wasn't close to the two towers. We heard this loud, loud noises, and the building, I guess, was pancaking on itself. And I looked to the right and saw a huge fireball coming at us. And I just screamed to John, run. And then I woke up 3 days later in the hospital. Like burns on 60% of my body. I had a broken bone in my back, a nice laceration to my head. And my contact lenses were melted to my eyes, but I survived.
When you look back at that and when you think about that day, what do you remember most?
The panic, the loss, right? It's, I lost 61 colleagues. I lost a really good friend there. Retelling the story brings me back into the stairwell. And I know if I would have gone back to get people, I wouldn't be here today.
The healing, I would guess, never ends, but you sound like you're in a good spot now. What's that process been like?
So the first few years were, I was void, I was blank, I was absent, right? I didn't want to hear the noise, didn't want to hear the kids, didn't want anything. But as time goes on, you learn to do different things. I studied positive psychology now. I just try to help people out. I do a lot charity-wise and try to do things. You know, I'm fortunate, I'm lucky. So I try to do things to help others out as well. After 20 years, I sort of come to terms with where I am and what happened to me and how I can move forward. So I'm doing all right. Still have 2 feet on the ground, which is a bonus.
So many miracle escapes.
Yeah, hell of a tale.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And to turn that such a tough time into what is a positive now. He's doing lots of work with survivors, with all different kinds of people to help them make the tough times in their life easier and to help them get back on their feet, as he says. An incredible fella.
What a remarkable life.